Just like I said, the purity of woman is chastity, in the same way, the purity of man is also celibacy. Just like it is very rare to find a chaste lady, in the same way, it is very rare to find a chaste, surrender, submissive disciple. Any time in the Shastra talks about the chaste lady, it may be Kardam Devahuti, or now we are seeing this Chavan and Sukanya, Atri or Anusaya. In the same way, we can compare this to a surrender, dedicated, chaste disciple and spiritual master. Just like chastity is for women, celibacy is for a man. We will talk a nice pastime from Mahabharata, how a chaste and surrender disciple of a guru, how he is glorified in Shastras like anything. And I personally like this personality and the story, and I take inspiration from this personality. And he is none other than the son of Brihaspati, Kach. The story begins like that. One time, the demigods, they were repeatedly defeated by the Asuras, and the Daitya Guru, Shukracharya, knew the Sanjeevani Mantra. What is that Sanjeevani Mantra? He could revive anyone after dying. But Brihaspati doesn't know. So all the demigods, they thought what to do. Even after killing the demons are coming back again. Reincarnation. In the same body. What to do? They are thinking. And they went to Kach, the son of Brihaspati. They requested him, "My dear Kach, you go to Shukracharya and learn this mantra." Which mantra? Vritti Sanjeevani. Our mantra is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So Kach, by hearing the appeal or request of Devguru, all the demigods, he went to the Shukracharya. And Shukracharya was that guru of the demons. And he had a very beautiful daughter, Devyani. You remember Devyani, the wife of? What is it? Jajati? Jajati's wife, what is his name? Devyani and Sarmishta, no? Okay, Devyani. So Devyani was the daughter of Shukracharya. And Kach went to Shukracharya. That time they were the Vrishaparva was the king of the demons. This comes in 9th canto. Yeah, the story will come. So he requested, and he was so honest. He said that. And Brihaspati and Shukracharya, they are like 36. You understand what is 36? Completely opposite. Sattis ka akada, they say, na? Completely against. Shukracharya and Brihaspati will never go together. They are dead against. But still, the son of Brihaspati came to Shukracharya. Those days, the personalities are so advanced in the culture. The Kach say that, "I am the son of Brihaspati. Come to you to learn the Mruti Sanjeevani. But at the same time, I am saying you that I will follow whatever you say. Whatever condition you will say, but I want to become your disciple. I want to be your disciple." So Shukracharya was very pleased. Although he knew that he is coming from my against party, Brihaspati. But being a guru, he said, "Okay, I'll teach you. But you have to remain celibate. Brahmacharya for 1,000 years. Maintain celibacy for 1,000 years. And he said, "Okay, I am ready to follow. And you have to please me and my daughter at any cost, in any circumstance. You cannot displease my daughter. She is my lordly. She is very dear to me." And Kach agreed. And he started serving. He did all the service, Gosala Seva, Prasadam service, and Mangalarati, chanting Hare Krishna. Whatever the brahmacharis they do in ashram, Kach was doing all the services, practicing bhakti and everything exactly the Shukracharya said. So like this, 500 years passed and there was not a single mistake done by Kutch. And these asuras, the demons, they came to know that this our against Brihaspati's son has come to learn Mrutu Sanjivani, will finish him up. And he, the Kutch, was faithfully serving Shukracharya, also Devyani. Devyani was the young daughter of Shukracharya. She would ask, "My dear Kutch, can you get some flower?" Kutch would go and get flowers and woods, everything from the jungle. One day, Kutch went with the cows to the jungle. And there the demon saw the Kutch is there. And they captured him and they killed him. Killed him and threw the flesh to the dogs and vultures and the wolves. Finished everything, nothing was remained. When the cows came back, and Devyani, by the time Devyani fell in love with Kutch, because he was so pakka brahmachari and he was following all the religious principle, he was following all this vrata and upvas, everything, he was vows, commitments. And so she, Devyani, requested her father, "My dear father, Kutch has not yet come, all the cows came, something disaster might have happened." So Brihaspati, Shukracharya could understand something had happened and he must have died. With the Mrutu Sanjivani mantra, he revived Kutch, and by tearing apart the stomach of dog and wolf and vulture, the Kutch revived as it is. And Kutch came to the house again. And Devyani was very pleased. "My dear Kutch, Prabhu has come back." And Kutch was again as usual serving the ashram, Mangalarati, Japa, Guru Puja, Bhagavatam, all the norms he was following, and he was serving in the ashram all this seva. Another time, again, when he went to the forest, this demon, again he was revived. He said, "This time we will kill him." And so what they did, all the demons, they caught him and they killed him and they put it in the mixture and grind and mix it and they threw in the ocean. So now no one can revive him. Second time. Again, Devyani saw Kutch has not come back, and Devyani again cried before her father, "My dear father, where is my Kutch Prabhu? He has not yet come, and ashram is completely empty." And again, Shukracharya said, "He must have died." And then he chanted the mantra, Mrutu Sanjivani. As soon as he chanted the Mrutu Sanjivani mantra, Kutch came out from the ocean. Just see, that's the power of mantra. He came out from the ocean. Again, he came back to the ashram and they were asking, "Where are you?" And he said everything. He was so truthful and honest. He said, "The demons caught me, they killed me, and the mixer in the grinder, they mixed me and put it in the ocean," like that. And some years passed like this. Kutch was, as usual, following the path and serving in the ashram. And this time the demon thought that, we'll kill him in such a way that he will never come back again. You know what they did? First they killed him. They caught him, they killed him, and they burned him. After burning, they powdered him and mixed it in liquor. In modern day, you can say bagpiper or whatever. And they gave it to Shukracharya only. And Shukracharya unknowingly, they said that my disciples, demons, are giving some nimbu pani sikanji. And he drank it. The Kutch went inside. So he went inside. Now again Devyani requested, "My dear father, where is Kutch? Kutch is not here. They killed him. Please do something." And this time Kutch from in remaining in the stomach, he answered that, my dear Guru Shukracharya, I am in your stomach, within your stomach. Oh my God, you are inside me only. Then Shukracharya was surprised. Oh, now what to do? He said to the daughter, this, just see Devyani. So you choose one of us, either father or Kach. You want father or Kach Prabhu? You choose one of the us, because Kach is inside me. And actually he didn't know, unknowingly he drank. The demons gave him, unknowingly he drank. And that time in Mahabharata tradition, he chastised, he condemned himself, and he gave a kind of curse, a warning to all the Brahmanas. He said, whoever the Brahmanas in the whole earth, either Mishra or Pande or Upadhyay or Tripathi, whoever is there, if they drink liquor, their piety, purity, everything will destroy and they'll go to hell. Like that, he announced, Shukracharya, I drank unknowingly, now I am suffering. My dear disciple is inside my womb. Now he announced like that, he warned. Anyway, the Devyani said, my dear father, I want you and also Kach Prabhu. Both, and I don't want to miss anyone. You are my dear father and he is my dear Kach. So what to do now? Now then Shukracharya said that, my dear disciple Kach, at this time I am giving you the Mrut Sanjeevani mantra for which you had come. And you learn it, you come out from my body, tearing apart my stomach, and again you revive me. So like that, the disciple remaining inside thing, okay, my dear Guru Maharaj, please give me the mantra. So he chanted the Mrut Sanjeevani mantra. He got it. Kach tear apart this stomach of Shukracharya. He came out and father died. Shukracharya dead. And again by chanting the mantra, Shukracharya was revived. So Kach was totally indebted to Shukracharya and the daughter by her service. When the 1,000 years passed, now the climax scene. Now just hear attentively the climax. When 1,000 years passed, the Kach took the permission of the spiritual master Shukracharya, and also the daughter of Shukracharya, Devyani. Can I go to my ashram back, heavenly planet? So Devyani said, my dear Kach, do you remember, whenever you are dead, who revived you? I only revived by telling to my father. So you are indebted to me, you are grateful to me, and also I love you, I like you. So please accept me as are your wife. At that time, Kach, what the reply, the way he replied, it was really in the history of Bharatavarsha or Vedic period, for the rest of the eternity, it will remain always in the golden letter, that how the Kach replied. Kach replied that, you are the daughter of my guru, so you are my guru behen. You are my sister, and the place from where you born, I also born from that same place. That is from the stomach of your guru, of my guru. The place from where you born, exactly from that place, I also born from the stomach of my guru. So in this way, you are my sister. I cannot even think of this thing, what you are saying, that to getting married. Please forgive me. So you are like my sister. Come on Balram Purnima to tie the rakhi. So he didn't say, I am just saying that. But he rejected the proposal. He rejected completely. And Devyani became furious. She became completely disturbed that I am a Brahmin. You are a Brahmin. You are the son of Angira, the grandson of Angira, and then Bruhaspati, and you are the son of Bruhaspati. I am the son. What is the difficulty? We are in same Gotra, we are same Brahmana. So what is the, why are you rejecting? Like that he said. And Kach said, no. As I said you that my Guru Maharaj, my father has sent me, my demigods have sent me to learn some Vidya from here, not to get married here. There is a mission why I have come here. My spiritual master Shukracharya never told me to get married. My Guru Maharaj never told me. You are saying, not your father. My spiritual master never told me. My spiritual master never told me. My father never told me. My demigods have never told me. I have just come to learn Vidya. My job is over. So now I have to be back. So please forgive me. At that time, Devyani cursed him. You are rejecting my proposal. Just see the nature of the world. If you reject the proposal, what happens? She cursed him that you will forget the Mrutyu Sanjeevani mantra. Anytime you want to remember it, you will forget it. And Mahabharata, in the sloka it is written that Kach also cursed her, that you are cursing me for this silly reason, I reject your proposal, now I curse you. He also cursed that. No Brahman will marry you. You will marry with the lower caste, lower than the Brahmana. Therefore, Yayati got married with the Devyani. But my dear devotees, the story doesn't end here. Kach said to Devyani, I cannot remember the Mrutyu Sanjeevani mantra, what I learned from my spiritual master, but it will not work, you are saying, but I will give this Vidya to others. I will give this mantra to others. If he chants, then it will work. Like that it is said. And he went back to the demigods. The demigods were so happy. Kach Prabhu has come back as it is. And he taught that mantra to some of the demigods. And the demigods got that mantra. And since then, they have become immortal. My dear devotees, point is that just like it is very rare to find a chaste lady who is totally devoted to her own husband, in the same way, it's very rare to find a chaste disciple who only follows the spiritual master and dedicates his life to the order of the spiritual master, who is stick to his mission, that why we have come here and getting the pure devotion.